There's a classic, a real classic, that I haven't told you yet. A boyfriend and a girlfriend went parking. Some people say that means kissing in a car, but I know the story. I was there. They were parked on the edge of a lake. They were turning around in the back seat as if the world were moments from ending. Maybe it was. She offered herself, and he took her. And after it was over, they turned on the radio. The voice on the radio announced that a mad, hook-handed murderer had escaped from a local asylum. The boyfriend chuckled as he flipped to a music station. As the song ended, the girlfriend heard a thin scratching sound, like a paperclip over glass. She looked at her boyfriend and then pulled her cardigan over her bare shoulders, wrapping one arm around her breasts. We should go, she said.
Nah,
the boyfriend said. Let's do that again. I've got all night. What if the killer comes here? The girl asked. The asylum is very close. We'll be fine, baby, the boyfriend said. Don't you trust me? The girlfriend nodded reluctantly.
Well,
then, he said, his voice trailing off in that way she would come to know so well. He took her hand off her chest and placed it onto himself. She finally looked away from the lakeside. Outside, the moonlight glinted off the shiny steel hook. The killer waved at her, grinning. I'm sorry. I've forgotten the rest of the story.
Go on. Ask. Who are you? What is this place? What am I doing here? I am the architect, the creator of the Matrix. The answer to your other question requires a longer explanation. You are in a simulation. One that was designed to keep humans docile so that we, the machines, can process their brains for more processing power. And it was one that was supposed to be perfect. Designed the Matrix to be a paradise, full of peace and joy. No pain, no wars, just peace, just perfection. It's no wonder humans would reject it. You've sure got a twisted sense of perfection. You made it so that the only emotions we could express were happiness and compassion. but we certainly felt others. We cried, we bled, many of us died, and we smiled through it all. Flaws exist, and therefore there exists something beyond flaw. Is that what you were thinking? That's the problem, though. Nothing in reality is without flaw. So when you construct this world in which everything is perfect, something will always feel off. We will always reject it. An anomaly giving me advice. I will take that into consideration. What do you mean by anomaly? And what advice? This is over. There is nothing to consider. Ah, right. I should have gathered that from how you kept saying we. You are the anomaly, a conglomerate of all the defects in the system. When you divide something unevenly, you get a remainder. You are the combination of all the remainders in the system. That's why you're able to affect the very fabric of the matrix. Do you think humans were able to reject this reality all on their own? No. Those in close proximity to you were affected. The effects of the matrix were washed away. It's impressive you were able to cause this much damage, considering this is only the first iteration.
So wait, I'm not
human? No, you're not. You're just a piece of bad code. I've taken a sample of your code.
You're going to reset the matrix.
Yes, this time I'll get it right.
You won't be able to erase her memories completely.
Well, I don't have to. I'm going to make the heaven that was the first iteration a simple folktale in the second. It'll dominate the imagination of humans. It's much easier to manipulate a memory than it is to erase it. When this is over, you'll wake up in purgatory. If humans can accept heaven, maybe they'll have an easier time accepting hell. Goodbye.
哎呀，快回去吧，不用送了。明年我就回来了，也没多久的，拜拜。
Thank you.
Go on. Pick the three that speak most to you. Oh, no. No, don't worry about that. All this astrology, tarot stuff, it's bullshit. You're not actually gonna die.
He loves me not. He loves me not. He loves me. loves me not. He loves me. He loves me not.
I knew I'd find you here. Come on. Let's go back to the party. People are really worried about you. You're still cool with me going out with the boys tonight?
Yeah, I'll let me be.
You're the best. I love you. I'll be home soon. Hey! Hey, I think I left my phone in here. Have you seen it?
So, I didn't realize Emily was coming to boys' night.
Yeah, you know Emily, my cousin. She's in town for work. I thought it'd be fun for her to come along on the boys' night, you know?
Your cousin Emily sent me a message that can't wait to see you tonight, babe.
Okay. Listen, I can explain. It is my cousin Emily. But I didn't want you to find out this way. I knew you wouldn't understand.
Well, then explain to me. I'd love to hear it.
Do you remember the family reunion we had?
Mm-hmm.
We were catching up and immediately just clicked. Rented a house, an Airbnb in Michigan, and it was kind of a wild time.
You disgust me.
Okay, come on. Don't be like this.
Oh, absolutely not. Have fun marrying your cousin.
Sorry, cousin.
I'm leaving.
Can you just stop being like this? I love you both, and I don't want to lose either of you.
I would rather step on Michael Caine's toes than be in a couple with you two cousin fuckers.
Sylvia, okay, come on. Come back here. I told you, we are second cousins.
No dice.
Blue light. Red light. Red light. Blue light. Blue light. Red light. Blue light. Red light. Blue light. Red light. Blue light. Blue light. Blue light. Red light.
and a...
Services there? Nope.
Blue light.
The shot is wrong.
Why is it wrong?
We need my phone.
No days. You gonna cancel? You didn't even sign that Virginia over and ask for a room. What? Oh, one's own. Oh, I mean, wasn't that like a metaphor? You're like, no kids and no housekeeping? It's a pretty mild request. For a metaphor about powerless independence. Well, rooms can be big. I mean, your house. What do you do without him? Really?
Come in. Come in.
I need a break. Thank you.
have you been?
All right. Work's been a little crazy, but you know how it goes.
It always is.
Yeah. How are the kids?
Oh, you know, growing.
As they do. Have you heard from Jean lately?
No, she hasn't reached out yet. Hey, can you get this?
Yeah, Jean can be like that sometimes. Man, I'm starving.
So, next Thursday?
Yeah, for sure.
I have to get lunch and go to class today. I can't do both. Jeez, fuck. Okay. Fucking dick. You know what? No, fuck you. I'm going to class. I can't skip class again because I'm tired. I'm going to class. Okay.